I do think Bill Barr felt like he had to say something. I do think it is remarkable that Bill Barr also said this was my decision. I don't think we understand yet, in terms of the Stone case, exactly what happened and how it was that it went from 7 to 9 and what Barr knew to this recommendation for sentencing being changed. And that'll play out in the coming days. But he was facing enormous pressure within the Justice Department. He was facing threats, of people either leaving or losing confidence in him. He had to say it, but there's just no way that the president's going to hear those comments from anything that any of us know of him over the last several years. I really can't see him hearing Bill Barr criticizing how he uses Twitter, which he considers so important to how he communicates, and his form of independence in this job. And I can't see him hearing that and saying, yes, I get it. That's cool. I just don't.
You know, the question is, Maggie, what does he do? What does the president do about it? Barr is his last friend, his ally. He's had another attorney general he fired. So what does he do facing this kind of criticism from his ally?
But remember, Gloria, he fired Sessions after almost 2 full years of simmering about Jeff Sessions. So we might get 8 months up to a reelection vote of the president simmering about Barr. We might get Barr leaving on his own. We might get nothing. I think that the president recognizes that it would be really traumatic for his administration to lose the attorney general right now, eight and a half months before election day. But that doesn't mean he's not going to be unhappy about this. And he is in this kind of phase of feeling unfettered after impeachment. This is not what he wants to hear.
As somebody